so advanced, they can produce so quickly, the markets are soaked. So they can't make the profit. And a capitalist won't sell you nothing if they can't make a profit. The banks won't lend money if they can't make a profit. So what the banks are doing here and around the world is they're lending money with skyrocketed interest rates. And what they do is they tell the governments that you have to cut back on all the social services. All over the world they're saying you got to cut back on schools, on education, on vital necessities for survival for people. Cut them back, austerity. So what we have to do is we have to say, no, there is money. When they try to go after the unions, after the pensions, when they try to take the teachers from your schools, when they try to take the food out of your children's mouths, we have to say, the hell with that. There is money. Take it from the military. Take it from the banks. We're not going to take this crap anymore. Don't let them put you in their little paradigm, their argument that doesn't allow you to look at all of the trillions of dollars that are going away to the banks and to the corporations and to the rich. We have access to that money. They stole that money from us in the first place. That's what we have to demand, and that's what the anti-war movement has to continue to take up. Because we need to fight, and people all over the world are fighting for what they struggled for years, for Social Security, for unemployment benefits, for all of those things. We need to fight for that, and we're going to fight for that. And that's the key thing is they struggled for that. They did it. We did it. Not the politicians. I don't care whether they're the Democrats or the Republicans. The only people that are going to make real change is the people sitting around here that you're looking at. The movement. We got to build a movement of unity. A movement of unity. Forget about the sectarian things. Forget about all of that stuff. We need to be united and fight in the struggles and fight with the folks. So we're so proud that this was endorsed by many of the organizations, many of the immigration organizations, social justice organizations, police brutality organizations. All of us have to come together, and we need to build this movement. So with that, I just want to introduce Julio Rodriguez, who was gracious enough to allow us to hear his poetry. The Conga poet, who's been around the struggle for a long time. He helped with Carlos Montes' struggle when the FBI were after him. So let's hear it for Julio Rodriguez.
Julio Rodriguez. Hey now.
Just 1, 2. Little problem here. I needed an extension stand. Can you hear me?